Welcome back to my channel. I cannot believe it, but today's video is going to be my first fall video, and that seems absolutely insane to me. Where did the summer go? I don't know, but here's fall, and so I'm wearing dark lips, because obviously. If you're new to my channel and have not yet subscribed, definitely hit that subscribe button, because this month I'm giving away a Nurban. I was just about to combine Urban Decay and Naked all in one word. That's not gonna work. Anyway, so I'm giving away an Urban Decay and Naked Smoky palette this month. It's a really awesome palette. You're definitely gonna wanna enter. So yeah, all you have to do is be subscribed. That's the only rule. You can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, Facebook, all those other things for extra entries. But yeah, only rule is you need to be subscribed. So in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you three different fall recipe treat ideas, and I'm obsessed with how they turned out. I really like them. So I hope you guys enjoy it as well. And speaking of cozying up and getting really into the fall time, I always like to cozy up to a new book or just a book in general for the fall time. And I wanted to talk about a book that I was recently sent. You guys probably know her already, Sierra Furtado, great YouTuber, but she's coming out with a book in October and I got a sneak preview of it. So this is what I've been reading recently. You can pre-order the book now, but it is going to be coming out on the 18th of October. And it's basically just about like a vlogger and like her lifestyle with boys and high school and all those kind of things. I may be 20, turning 21, but I still love this kind of stuff. So I'm really excited to continue reading this, and you guys should definitely check out the book if you're interested. I'm sure you guys know who she is, but yeah, I'll have information down below if you wanna go check it out. And we should all go support a fellow YouTuber. I do also know that Sierra is doing a few locations for a book signing tour. So if you guys live in like Seattle, San Fran, or Los Angeles, definitely go to her book signing, meet her, and get your book signed, because that would be really awesome. And yeah, I'm really excited to read the rest of that book. Thank you so much to Sierra for sending me an advanced copy. And yeah, let's go ahead and jump into the fall treats. Right now, let's do it. Here we go.
All right, so the first recipe I'm gonna be sharing with you guys are for these pretzel pumpkins. Basically, they're just chocolate covered pretzels that end up looking like pumpkins. And they're really, really easy to make. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is melt your chocolate. And of course you can use regular white chocolate and just dye it orange with some food coloring. However, I just use some regular candy melts from Michael's. They're really easy because they come in absolutely every color. So obviously I got the orange one and then melted that down. And then you just wanna take your pretzel and then roll it around on the inside till you get it completely covered. And then go ahead and put it onto a baking tray of some sort and definitely lay down some parchment paper or something so they don't stick. And then taking some green M&Ms, I'm just putting that in the crevice of the pretzel at the top to make the pumpkin stem. And then this is optional, but I added some really pretty orange sprinkles and then I just let them harden. They will set on their own. However, I did put them in the fridge for a few minutes just to really harden. And then once that is done, you can go ahead and take them out and put them into any dish you like and go ahead and enjoy them. They are such an easy treat to make and I think they're really festive and fun. Moving on, we're gonna be making some chocolate covered apple slices. I got this idea on Pinterest and I thought it was so cute that I really wanted to try it out for myself. So you wanna start off by cutting up an apple. You can probably get 4 slices out of a single apple because you kinda do want them to be a little bit wider. And yeah, so go ahead and cut your apple. And then after that is done, go ahead and take some skewers and just poke those into the bottom. These ones seem to hold up really well and I like them especially because they have a pointy side, so that really helps them dig into the apple. Next, all you're gonna wanna do is melt some chocolate. Again, I just use candy melts from Michael's. You can use whatever chocolate you want. And then I also melted down some orange and some white chocolate as well, just to add more fun to the decorating part of it. So all you have to do is cover your entire apple and then go ahead and decorate it. So I just added some white chocolate and some orange chocolate. It's not orange flavored, but you know what I mean. And then I just added some M&Ms to one, some sprinkles to other. You can really do whatever you want. There's so many options with this. I even thought, after I'd filmed the video, obviously, about doing an Oreo one. I think that would be delicious. Like I said, there's so many options and you can really customize it, or you can have a bunch of friends over and you can all customize your own. I think this would be really fun for a sleepover or just kind of any get together you guys might have with your friends this fall, because they're really delicious and a really good movie snack. Once I had completed decorating them, I stuck them into the fridge just to really set and harden, and then you can basically take them out and enjoy whenever.
Moving on, I'm going to be testing a pumpkin pie milkshake recipe, and I'm really excited because pumpkin flavored anything is pretty much my favorite, along with milkshakes. So I'm really excited for this, and all you're going to need is some ice cream, some puree pumpkin, like pure, I just use the stuff in the can, pumpkin pie spice, whipped cream, optional, caramel, optional, milk. You can choose whatever kind of milk you want, and then a blender. I don't have an actual blender, so I'm using my magic bullet, but yeah, let's go ahead and get started. I don't have the blender cup, so let's go get that first. All right, now that I have an actual cup to put all the things in, I'm gonna start off with the ice cream. The recipe that I'm following off Pinterest said to put 2 cups, but again, I have a little blender, so I'm going to pretty much like cut the recipe in half. So I'm gonna go with, like 4 scoops of ice cream. We'll see how it goes. And I got Häagen-Dazs vanilla bean, not just vanilla, because vanilla bean is far better than just plain vanilla. This is gonna use up the entire carton for this one milkshake, so. Moving on, I'm going to be putting in some milk. Again, you can use whatever kind of milk you want. That was probably too much. Oh well. I'm also going to be putting in my pure pumpkin, which looks nasty, but also smells questionable, but you know, this is what makes it pumpkin-y. Now I'm gonna put in some pumpkin pie spice. I've never opened this before, so I should do that first. And this is a half teaspoon. Teaspoon? Yeah. I'll put like half of that, a little bit of that. Now I'm just gonna put the top on and blend it up. It's pretty liquidy, so I'm going to add a few, it's like really liquidy. I'm gonna add a little bit more ice cream. Oh my god, it's like the perfect amount of jar. Yay! And now the best part is the toppings. So I'm gonna start off with some whipped cream. Now for the caramel, maybe. Sure. Okay, and then just some festive sprinkles. And then, of course, I'm just topping it off with a cute straw, and there you go. You have a pumpkin pie milkshake. It's so cute, but let's go ahead and test it out because I'm a little nervous. That's really good. It's really like pumpkin pie-y. It's not like PSL, obviously, there's no coffee in it, but this tastes exactly like a pumpkin pie. Wow, this just got me in the fall spirit like so much. Oh my god, that's so good. I'll just be here drinking this, honestly. Definitely giving this one a 10 out of 10. I would 100% make this again, and I would 100% recommend you guys to try this one out. Leave me a comment down below which treat you like the best and maybe which one you're actually going to try out. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel before you leave and give this video a thumbs up so more people can find this video and my channel in the future. And just so I know you guys like these kind of videos. And I will see lovely people in my next one. Have a great day. Bye.